Today at ShopTap.com, we're going to be talking about tuning our B8.5S4. Okay, so before we go and flash our vehicle, let's talk about software for this engine. 3OT, obviously supercharged engine. A big difference you see between this and most VW and Audi models use turbo engines, which respond very well to tuning. That's mostly because you can change boost along with a bunch of other stuff to gain more power. Now, because this is a supercharged engine, the boost is controlled by the supercharger, and generally the size of the pulley dictates maximum boost. So you can't raise the boost pressure, but they can make some adjustments. So one of the ways they actually make that possible is by taking the supercharger, has a bypass valve. Basically, whenever it's intending to not have the supercharger creating boost, it opens up the bypass valve. So it will keep the bypass valve closed more often during just operation in general, when maybe the factory software wouldn't. This would actually keep it shut to make sure that more boost is going to be going into the engine. With that said, power for this. So Stage 1 Plus, which is going to be optimized for 93 octane, is going to have around an 80 horsepower bump, about 35 pound-feet of torque. And so that's what we're going to be starting with. We will be doing future stuff, which is Stage 2, and then what Unitronic calls Stage 3, which is the dual pulley. So first Stage 2, we're going to do single pulley, then the dual pulley. And so we'll be going through each step of this as we go. But today we're going to be going with our Stage 1 Plus, and let's go ahead and take a look at that. Okay, so we are going to be flashing our car today. This is something you can do from home yourself with a UniConnect cable. We actually have a complete DIY video showing you a start to finish process with a UniConnect cable. It gives you the ability to flash your car at home, flash your car back to stock if you, for example, might want to take it to the dealer, you know, those type of scenarios. We are going to be flashing it today with the dealer software, because obviously we're a Unitronic dealer, and at our shop, we do software installs here for customers. So we're not going to be showing you the process today, but no, we will link to the complete video showing you the DIY with a UniConnect cable that you can do at home in the description below. Okay, so we are currently in the process of flashing the car. One note we actually have on this car and most current model cars is you'll oftentimes get a lot of communication faults relating to that, because once you start overwriting the ECU software, is you start getting missing messages for all the control modules that are supposed to talk to the engine control module. So oftentimes you'll get faults that flash on screen and create beeping noises and blah, 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 and all that stuff. So just something to be aware of when you're flashing any car. That's going to be pretty standard, and you are going to want to make sure you erase the faults with something like either VAGCOM or OBD11 afterwards. The UniConnect cable has access to engine control modules, and then also I think they can read trans control modules, but you're going to have faults in a lot of other places because the car has, you know, a bunch of modules that talk to the ECU aside from those two. So that's going to create some problems, and we're going to continue flashing our car. Okay, so we just finished up with our tune. We are now going to grab our OBD11, plug it into our OBD2 port, scan it for fault codes. So we're going to do that now. As you can see, 15 faulty control units found. I'm not going to look at them. You would push there to look at them. It says hold to clear faults. So we're just going to hold this to clear all the faults, because we know most of these were set off by the tune. And no faulty control units. I am just going to run in here real quick. And I'm just going to jump in here and do a throttle adaptation real quick. It's really just a force of habit. It's good to have the throttle body basically know where it's supposed to be, and we're just going to let that run before we go ahead and test drive. Now that we finish with erasing our faults, we can start it up. Supercharger noise. Oh yeah. So my initial reaction definitely pulls harder all the way through the RPM range, which would make sense not being, you know, the big torque bump, but power No question, this is a no-brainer must for anybody who has a 3OT car, S4, S5, whatever, you know, any other car. You do get more supercharger noise, which was, I guess, not surprising keeping when they keep the bypass valve open or shut more. But good to hear a little more supercharger noise. Okay, so I waited a week of kind of feeling through the car before making kind of a reaction to, so I can give a better understanding of kind of the way the tune feels as we go through it. First thing is, we haven't done a DSG tune yet, but we are going to do one in the future. But in, you know, from my experience just in general with this car and really most DSG cars, in drive, they're kind of flaccid, for a lack of a better term, when you drive them, and you really only get to feel some real pep in it when you're in sport. So when you're in sport with this car now, after tuned, coming off the line is not as hard because the torque number isn't a huge increase, but once you get it going, there's a pretty significant increase in power that I've been super happy with. And again, you're going to see it mostly in higher RPMs or not immediately off the line because it's not torque, more horsepower than torque. So you feel it, and it's real strong, but it comes on strong and pulls all the way through, as opposed to you know, running out of steam where it may have before. Thanks so much for watching our tune video, and hopefully the reaction gave you a little bit of insight into tuning your S4. To me, on any 3OT car, I would absolutely tune it. It is going to be the best bang for your buck to modify your car.